Let's see who it's going to be. It's going to be Grover Cleveland Alexander. All Pete will come on.
The most unheralded in proportion to what he accomplished, in the words of the people who played with him and against him, is Grover Cleveland Alexander.
He had been a great pitcher as a young man and had to overcome a lot of physical problems. He was an epileptic and was a very heavy drinker, and that also could be a problem off the field.
All the old-timers I have talked to all my life put Walter Johnson and Grover Cleveland Alexander in the same category, the top two right-hand pitchers.
Alexander, some people think, the best pitcher ever. It suffices to say that if he was not the greatest of all pitchers, there was never anyone who was better.
I guess the most memorable thing in his career came very late in his career, in 1926 in the World Series against the Yankees.
The seventh game of the World Series, which is always a romantic event, is started by Jesse Haynes, a knuckleball pitcher. The bottom of the seventh, the Yankees load the bases, two out. Haynes can go no further. His fingers are bleeding from throwing that knuckleball.
Haynes will be relieved, and I can't tell who's going to come in. It is going to be Grover Cleveland Alexander. Old Pete will come on.
He said they were younger men in the bullpen, fresher arms.
In the sixth game, he pitched a complete game victory to even the series at 3-3 for the St. Louis Cardinals.
This was a legend walking in. It was a gray afternoon, Yankee Stadium, walking in out of the mist. This was the man they believed in.
All Pete will come on. The veteran Alexander will try to put out the fire here in the last half of the seventh inning.
And he got near the mound, and Hornsby walked over to second base, met him as he came in, looked in his eyes, and he said, "Pete, bases loaded, two out. Well, there ain't no place to put anybody as a Raj."
He'll first be faced by Tony Lazzari.
Rookie Tony Lazzari, hard-hitting, tough-minded, young second baseman.
Again, the runners take their long two-out, bases loaded leads.
And he told Hornsby, "I'm going to pitch the first one, fastball inside, and if he hits it, it'll be foul." And Hornsby said, "No, you can't do that. He's a fastball hitter." And Alexander said, "If I put it where I want to put it, he's going to hit it foul if he hits it at all." And then Hornsby looked at Alexander and said, "Well, who the hell am I to tell you how to pitch?" And Alexander said, "Then I'm going to curve him low and away. 1, 2, 3. And that's exactly what happened.
Again, the runners take their long two-out, bases loaded lead. Pitches. Swing on and miss for strike three. And that is all for the New York Yankees in the last half of the seventh inning, as Al Pete comes in a situation that will go down as one of the most dramatic moments in all sports, and strikes out, push him up Lazzari with the bases full.
Into the mythological books of baseball history goes Alexander and his strikeout of Lazzari, which a lot of historians like to look upon as the ultimate generational challenge in baseball history.